All right, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be giving you a tour of the new website that I've been working on. You've probably noticed that the website really hasn't had any changes done to it for quite a while now, and I've been getting some work done behind the scenes. It's just been taking me a little bit of time between doing all my regular work, and then this is kind of like my passion project here, so it's slowly coming along. But I gotta tell you, I'm happy as a pig in shit with how this website turned out, because it looks a hell of a lot better than it did before. So as far as how to get to the website, I've got it on a subdomain now because it's a different web platform than this one. And rather than getting yet another domain that I have to manage, I probably will at some point, but for the time being, I just made a subdomain for it. So it's cyber.kenharris.io. I haven't changed the link over yet, but you'll be able to go to the main website if you wanted to and click on cybersecurity and it will show up. And then these buttons here will, of course, take you back to the regular website. And then I will also have a link added in here. I'll have it listed as the first link. So the cyber.kenharris.io, that, because I figure that's why a lot of people probably come to the channel, is they want to get information that's related to computer somehow. So I'm going to go ahead and walk you through some of the stuff that's different on this website compared to the old one. I'm going to remove this link here pretty soon, so you're not going to be able to click on this and see the old stuff. All this content is going away on this website. But the way that I had it before was kind of a cluster, because when you clicked on something, you had to go into here, and then there was all these different tabs you had to click on. And it was kind of a mess, and it really wasn't formatted all that great. The problem is I had so much content on there that it just didn't work with the way that I had this website. So I went to this new one. I'm using MK Docs material as the base for this. So shout out to the dev team over there. They've done a really good job. Basically, it was between that and DocuSaurus. So I was like, well, this one looks the nicest between the two of them. So that's what I went with. And also, if you're wondering what's been changed on the website, I've got this banner up here at the top that says, to see what's been updated on the website, refer to the change log. If you click over on that, it'll take you back to the main website, like where down here you'd have the changelog. So the changelog is still also going to be on the old site. So the only thing that's on this new one now is the cybersecurity content that I've been making. So I'm going to go ahead and run through some of this stuff here real quick. So it now has a light theme and a dark theme. So depending on, I think it goes off of system preferences. So if you have Windows using light theme, then it's going to show up as light theme. When you open up the website, you can switch to dark just by pressing the button up here if you want to. The other thing is it now has a search function, which is a hell of a lot better. With all the information that I have on the website now, you can come up here and just go to the search bar and type in, and it will take you to, so you could search for something specific. So like if you wanted to do Microsoft Defender Application Guard, for example. I'm gonna still be working on a lot of the content here, but like if someone was coming in here and they had like some sort of a problem setting it up, like just as an example, is a lot of people like to turn off, or some people like to turn off hyper-threading, like on especially the Intel CPUs, because it cuts down power usage. But then if you do that, Microsoft Defender Application Guard won't work. And then if someone doesn't know that, they'll be like, well, why in the hell isn't it working? And so they could come in here. And like I said, I haven't had it added that specific instance in here, but the search function is super powerful. All you have to do is type in something specific and it will take you through all the different sections of the website. The other thing is there are now admonitions on the website. This is a lot better than how I did it before, where it was like just these little emojis and it just didn't fit well with the website. So now these admonitions are scattered throughout. Wanted to make sure these were super noticeable, something that people would pay attention to. So like the warning ones are super important to pay attention to, especially like for the encryption section. I use quite a bit of these. And then the other thing now is I'm slowly starting to go through. It's taking a little bit of time and I've got to figure out what applies where, because I don't want to have like a million external links, but I've got external links to point out like, okay, well, here's like an example of someone that had fake invoices where people were basically socially engineered and they were scammed out of a bunch of money, like going to like other videos or other websites or something to explain like a certain word, or in this case, things that come up like in the cybersecurity world. So I'm building out these links on here. The other thing that I'm doing is I'm going through and redoing all of the content. So far, the OPSEC section I have completely redone. So if you go in here, like the encryption, for example, like what I had before was pretty sparse. There wasn't a whole lot of information in there. If you go click on encryption now, there's quite a bit of new information that's in here. Also, you can see there's a table of contents over here. So you can click and go to a specific section. There's also like a little hyperlink here that will take you to that page, and then you could save it like in a resource or link library or whatever it is that you want to use. But I explain stuff quite a bit in quite a bit more detail now. And then I also have these admonitions built in for YouTube videos. So you'll be able to come in here, like I'm talking about BitLocker here, so you can open this up, watch a tutorial on how to set up BitLocker, watch a tutorial on how to use CryptoMator. Again, lots of admonitions. So I'm going through and rewriting all this content. So far, the only thing that I've made it through so far is the OPSEC section. I'm going to be working on getting the network security section updated next, and I'll go through like Windows and all that. Like I said, it's just kind of a slow process because I'm trying to work on this as I've got all my other day-to-day responsibilities to take care of. But the website seems like it's coming along pretty nice. This is a lot better than what I had on here before. The other thing, so I'm sure people noticed, is I also had a lot of personal opinions on the previous version of the website. I've got rid of a lot of those. Some of those are still around, like the VPN section. I'll probably rewrite this and change some things around on here. I don't think personal opinions are really going to do much for people that want to learn about cybersecurity, so I'll still have some of them if I really think they're relevant, but I've cut a lot of them out and kept it more objective. This is like version 2.0 of the content where I've gone in and like, so the OPSEC section, for example, like encryption, like I went through and rewrote everything. This is like version 2.0 of the website. Now the content is way more refined than what was there before. And at some point I'll go back and do like version 3.0 and refine it even further. So like you could come in and I'll eventually at some point have like here in the browser section, specific steps to set up like Defender Application Guard, for example, or specific steps to cut out Firefox telemetry, or how to set up Brave for like the most convenience and privacy and all that. And then at some point I'm also going to have a recommendation section, probably under the hardware and software here. Recommendations is like what I recommend for antivirus, which is Defender basically, or ClamAV if you're on Linux. Recommendations for like hardening tools, browsers, and then like I said, I'll be going through at some point in the future and rewriting a lot of the stuff that's in here, making it flow better, make sure things make more sense. But that's something I'm going to be looking for your feedback on. So whatever it is that you guys want to see on this website, just drop comments and let me know. Whatever, if you see anything that's wrong on the website, go ahead and let me know. If there's anything you want to see added, let me know. And then if there's any sort of improvements, like I don't want people to think that I'm some sort of oracle. I hate that the word expert gets thrown around so much these days. I'm not trying to pretend to be a cybersecurity expert. Like, yeah, I work in IT, but it's like, I don't really think that people should be throwing around the word expert nearly as much as they do. I'm not gonna pretend to be like some know-it-all. And like I said, if there's something on here that I have wrong, I'm more than willing to go back and get it fixed. So again, if you see anything in that regard, just go ahead and drop a comment down below and let me know. By the way, if you guys are curious, I figure people at some point might want to see a behind the scenes of how I made this website. A lot of this was done inside of Visual Code Studio, or Visual Studio Code. That's this application right here where I was going in and adding all the content, making changes to like YML files, doing some HTML modifications, stuff like that. If this is something you guys wanna see where I do behind the scenes, I might do it anyway because MKDocs material, like documentation websites are pretty popular or becoming more popular, mostly from within like certain companies or people have as like a personal library kind of thing. Like a lot of people wouldn't really use this as a public website where you could go find this stuff. There are a few examples of DocuSource. It was like going through the details of prompt engineering. It was actually, I do have the link right here. So this was made in DocuSource, I think. So pretty similar concept. You can see like it's got table of contents, nav bar here. It's got like the icons next to all this stuff, and you can click down and see more stuff. DocuSource was really nice. I just think for what I needed to do with a website, that MKDocs was the better choice to go with, but I'm not stuck on it. Maybe at some point I would switch, but I don't really see a reason to change what I'm using right now. So anything in particular you want to see, any bugs or anything that needs to get fixed or bad information or whatever, like I said, just go ahead and drop a comment down below. Let me know. Appreciate you sticking around this long, and I will see you on Monday.